Welcome. We are getting ready to do a premiere draft on MTG Arena, and it's going to be featuring Shadows over Innistrad Remastered. Now, this is a remastered set based off of the original Shadows over Innistrad. You're going to see a lot of those same cards, but potentially at slightly different rarities for some of them. So it could be just a little bit of a different feel, but overall, I am looking forward to this. I did play Shadows over Innistrad a decent amount. And before we do hop into the draft, it's a great time to level up your game with CFP Pro articles from some of the best players in the world, including myself. I write weekly articles for CFP Pro, but each month I write a special article called a deep dive article. And recently I did a deep dive on Celestnia Auras and Pioneer. And this is all part of the TCG Player subscription, so you're not only getting CFP Pro, you're getting free shipping on Direct Buy TCG Player orders, bonus bucks back on your orders, and this is all for only $7 a month. I also want to say thank you to Ultimate Guard. I recently joined the Ultimate Guard team, and I do appreciate their support. All right, you guys ready? Let's hop into this draft. All right, let's go ahead and let's do this. First pick, first pack, what do we have? Our rare is Voldaren Pariah. So you can sack three creatures to transform this. Pretty powerful. It also madnesses in. So I think we just want to take the rare. Building around this card. I mean, it's just a very powerful card. I think we just it's like a must pick. We are passing a Dustwatch Recruiter. Another good card. The captain means we're probably going to pass a vampires player close by to us, so we don't necessarily need to be vampires to oh wow. Okay, I am I think we know what we're gonna draft here, guys. This is a pretty nice start. I mean we do want to start thinking about just getting small creatures to be able to sacrifice to the pariah, which is going to allow us to make this abolisher of bloodlines. And then when it does transform, you know, opponent sacking three creatures, it can be really, really powerful. It's rare that you get the same rare, you know, double to start a draft, so this is exciting. All right, I don't hate Shrill Howler. Could take that. Gavinny Unhallowed. Not really a card I like to take super early in a draft. Yeah, I think I'll take Shrill Howler. So now I could follow up with Uvenwalt Captive or Ghoulcaller's Accomplice. I think it's between those two cards. If we wanted to, like, for sure be black-green, then I think Captive would be the pickup. But we're not, like, we're definitely not, like, definitely in black green at this point. Far from that. Yeah, I'm gonna take the accomplice here because we're not abandoning black. We could still be black green, and I don't think, this is still just a good two drop to have. Rapid Bite, not bad. The Mourn Willow is kind of interesting. It's not like it's that amazing, though. I actually think if we go black green, we might rather just take this Rapid Bite. Grapple with the Past. A little early for that. Yeah, I'm gonna take Rapid Bite. This could be, if we end up black red, this could be a make mischief sort of a deck, right? Like, the devils are good with the pariah. So, yeah, I'm actually gonna take make mischief out of this. Keep our options open. We still want to be playing the pariahs, clearly. But there's a lot of green now. Flowing. Green is now coming. Although this pack is just generally quite strong. And so, Noose Constrictor is good. So is Byway Courier. Byway Courier is very solid. I will probably take Noose Constrictor. Yeah, okay, that's close because there was a few different cards there that I wanted. So we are kind of heading in that black green sort of a direction. Wyrding Wood. It's kind of a cool card. I might take it. I might take Wyrding Wood. Also allows us to splash. Depending on how things play out here. This is a late Galvanic Bombardment. So I might just snap this up. It's kind of, could be a signal. Dusk Feaster, not bad. Foul Bloods also not bad. Same with Confront the Unknown. But I'm gonna take Bombardment because it's early and still trying to kind of read the draft. Figure out what's going on. Scarecrow. Scarecrow's kind of a cool card in some decks. Conduit of Storms is also here. I think I'm gonna take the Scarecrow, but that's kind of a weird pick. Grapple with the Past. If we do end up black green, we could end up with a Delirium based deck where Grapple is good. Don't think we're gonna play Moonlight Hunt, but we are getting towards the end of the pack. All right. We didn't get as much black as I was hoping for after that start, although here's a Noosegraaff Mob. pretty powerful card. So we could just add to our black rares, which seems like a pretty good place to be. I mean, double Pariah to start, and then we just pile on a bit with the Noosegraft Mob, which starts churning out a bunch of zombies. So yeah, happy with that. We'll grab it. And I think we're looking at black green. We did get like this late bombardment, which was just like a couple red cards, but overall we are looking at black green. So with that said, clear shot is quite nice. Maybe we'll even wheel the Foul Orchard out of this. Although I kind of doubt we do, because the pack's not that strong, but I am going to take clear shot. Devil's Playground. Dryad is good. So is Noose Constrictor. Giss's Bidding is pretty good also. But I think I'm just going to take the Constrictor. It's just a good 2-drop. Prioritize early on having good 2-drops. We can take Olivia's Dragoon if we want. It's not as good as Noose Constrictor, but it does mean we now would have like a bunch of 2-drops that are discard outlets, which can be kind of nice. Woodland Stream or Game Trail, I guess, if we wanted to splash. But yeah, I'm gonna take Olivia's Dragoon. Barred Malevolence is fine card. Flexible. We don't actually have, yeah, I think I will take that. Could see taking a number of cards out of this pack. Kind of similar power level between most of the cards. Wow, more Noose Constrictors. I'm happy with it. I think it's a good 2-drop. Okay, I love to see the Kindly Stranger still in the pack, because I do think with black-green you want some Delirium payoffs, and that is perfect for us. Gives us a more reason to want, you know, random artifacts, enchantments, stuff like that, but we'll see how things go. I don't know that we would actually necessarily play anything here. We've already got 2 grapples, so we're kind of like good on grapples at the moment, I feel. I'll grab the apparatus. Abundant Maw. Anguished Unmaking. Confront the Unknown. Yeah, nothing here I'm super interested in. We'll grab a confront. Yeah, I don't really want to play these confronts, but did take an early Scarecrow. We don't have many zombies for the Ghoul Razor. Guess I'll take another Scarecrow. Taking cards at this point that I'm not sure we will actually play. But seems okay. Terrarion we might actually want if we get, like, it's another one of those Delirium enabler types of cards. All right, so our rare for the third pack. Spirit of the Hunt. So it's definitely an interesting card to see here. Because we don't have a ton of werewolf stuff, really. It is, you know, a 3-mana 3/3 flash, which can be good. 3-mana 3/3 flash. I think it's better than Mournwillow. We already have a Rapid Bite and a Clear Shot, so I'm happy to take the Spirit of the Hunt. Wow, Spellqueller. If we were blue white, that would be very attractive to see at this point, but we're not. So, second Rapid Bite. Yeah, I guess I'll take that. Okay. Huh. Well, Pack Guardian is very good. I remember Pack Guardian being very good. There's a Blood Hall Priest, which is great in red black, but Byway Courier, Gissa's Bidding. Both of these cards would be really nice in our deck as well, by the way. So it's just a really overall really good pack. I'm gonna take Pack Guardian. Okay, we're going to have two Pack Guardians, it looks like. So, we've kind of just now, all of a sudden, just got, like, really high-quality creatures. I mean, yeah, our creatures in this deck are just fantastic. Macabre Waltz. Rebuy two creatures. I don't think we want another Weirding Wood. Yeah, I'll take them. I'll take the Waltz. Once again, we'll take a look during deck building. Try to get a feel of exactly what we want to do. Dryad is not bad. Accomplice is also not bad. Logger's not bad either. Dryad. Actually, I want this Accomplice, I think. That's close, but I actually like Accomplice quite a bit. Byway Courier is pretty strong. I think I take that even over the Skinner. Ooh, that's really nice. Super late dead weight. And this pack three has really just kind of... Everything's come together. Couldn't have asked for a better pack, I don't think. And we've got just... Yeah, so many good cards here. It's going to be... It's going to be a matter of finding cuts, really. Here's a look at the full list. We got a nice low curve. I don't know that we're gonna end up needing to play the Wildfield Scarecrows, because now that we've got the Pack Guardians, we are kind of more mid-range based than control based. I was kind of thinking earlier we'd be a little bit more control, but now it's just kind of like, I don't know, black-green. Yeah, just black-green value. Like, just good cards. We've got the Delirium theme, but we're not going too hard on that, right? Like, we've got the Kindly Stranger here, sure. We don't have, like, that many Delirium cards. We've got... It's a theme here, but it's not... I don't think we need the woods and the scarecrows, necessarily. Got that. Crow of Dark Tidings we can get out. Moonlight Hunt. I could play actually Moonlight Hunt because we got some stuff randomly, like the Double Pack Guardian, Spirit of the Hunt, Shrill Prowler, but I still probably won't play it. Probably won't play. Yeah, just making cuts at this point. Graph Rats randomly. Grapple with the Past. Mourn Willow. Yeah, Mourn Willow is just fine, right? Grapple. Probably don't need double Confront or double Terrarion. We want to have just a decent amount of creatures to flood the board with for our pariahs. Cabaret Waltz. So that this allows us to get back creatures, but also Grapple with the Past does as well, right? I think Grapple's probably better here. And we don't want too many of that type of card. Terrarion. So let's see. We can very easily get land and creature into the graveyard. Instant. Got a couple sorceries as well. The enchantment. I don't think we need Terrarion. So this is where things get a trickier. We're at 17 creatures, which is kind of nice, right? Because we do want a reasonably high density of creatures. And the deck just looks really, really solid, overall. Like, just very happy with it. I could cut Thraven Foulbloods. It's just okay. I could confront, I guess confront the unknown. It's really like plus one, get a clue. Yeah, it's probably cuttable. And then Thraven Foulbloods seems cuttable as well, just because we're not actually super Delirium based, right? We've got the Stranger, we've got the Mourn Willow. I think the grapples are just pretty good as a way to get back our really good creatures. Plus we didn't need another three drop, so this deck just looks super, super clean. I guess I could cut Borrowed Malevolence if I wanted to, but I think that card is just fine. Flexible. Yeah, I'm just super happy with the deck. All right, let's play with it. All right, we're on the play. This hand seems just fine. I am gonna keep it. Okay. Always love to draw a two drop right on time. We can just start getting aggressive. Not really too worried about Delirium. Just getting a 3-2 haste out when our opponent plays an enchantment to start seems good. Probably don't want to trade off the Mourn Willow. We do need to find another black source. Dragoons. Kindly Stranger. Let's play the Dragoons. So, yeah, another black source gives us Pariah mana. Seems like, okay, they're gonna bounce Mournwillow, and then if they attack, I was gonna block if they attacked there. Now I probably still just attack with Accomplice and play Valdiran Pariah. And this isn't the best board for Pariah, but it is still just a, a flyer. But now okay, now that they've played this docent of perfection, I'm starting to think this is probably the time where we want to be, transforming our pariah. Oh, here goes. So we do that. Now we get to get our Mournwillow down and just put max pressure on. And that's game. Okay, we're on the draw this time with a hand I'm not in love with because we don't have green. Yeah, we'll just mulligan that. This hand looks much better. I wonder if I do put back the Spirit of the Hunt. Although it's good with the Shrill Howler. If I was greedy, I might put Swamp back. Pretty greedy to do that though. Because if we just don't draw land, it's super bad. Right, I'm gonna put the Spirit of the Hunt on the bottom. Should have put the swamp back. Results-oriented thinking. We're all about that here. I don't mind the accomplice dying, so I think I'm just gonna. Oh wow. Well, that now we're in trouble. This is a really, really strong draw from our opponent. Jam the Byway Courier. Wow, this is, I mean, I guess I may need to play. Kind of draw out of this. Let's see what we grapple into. Pack Guardian. Kindly Stranger is also not bad. Yeah, let's take the Kindly Stranger. And then we'll go Dragoons. Cause I think we can get, well, we're one away from Delirium. If I had another green, I might have taken the Pack Guardian. Alright, well, looks like the game's gonna slow down just a tad, which could be good for us. Maybe not. I take it all back. Sweet draw, this game from our opponent. Alright, I'm gonna grapple, try to hit Delirium. No Delirium. I guess Noose Constrictor trades with the Herald. Okay, this is actually sweet. We can play Noose Constrictor and then potentially Madness. Madness in this Valdaren Pariah. That's pretty cool. Okay. Okay, so we've set up an interesting board position. Now I could do this in response, sack everything, transform. Yeah, let's try it. Let's go for it. Boom. Pariah hits play. Now we activate. They're not going to get to draw the card. They sacrifice their board. We have a 6/5 flyer. We have a 6/5 flyer. That was huge. So don't think get. I think I just want to draw a card because I don't think getting this accomplice out really is going to matter. So we could deal 6, but then they deal 2 back. Is that worth it? Puts them to 14. The answer is I really don't know. All right. We're hoping they just don't have much left. Unfortunately for us, they do still have good stuff left. Yeah, this looks like GG. This looks like GG. Even if I was at 6, they would still have lethal. It's a good game. We almost clawed our way back, but yeah, just too much gas for our opponent there. Alright, we're going second, we're gonna keep. Missing green though. So this hand is dicey. It is dicey. We've got, I think, nine forests in the deck. But might be a sad pack guardian. Might be a sad pack guardian here. I stand by the keep though. If I was on the play, I probably would have mulliganed. But we have this extra draw step, which is big, to potentially get, you know, have that opportunity to get there. Drawing a bunch of green cards, not what I had in mind, of course. And now we're probably going to lose. Well, unfortunate. Maybe we're not out of it yet. Play this byway courier. That's frustrating. I mean, our opponent's draw hasn't been that great either. I could grapple into land, but then still not great, so I'll just play Byway Courier again. Yep, no good options. We'll grapple with the past. Get a forest. We can grapple again. I really would love the new Scrap Mob, but it's probably just way too greedy to take that. Alright, let's just take a land. Trying to set up these fight spells. Gonna be hard to do. All right, I think the chances of this play working out is quite low. All right, well, let's main phase Pack Guardian. Line, rapid bite. Okay. We're still in it. They have a 3-4 prowess. Take 4. Probably just make the same play here, honestly. Huh. I'm not really seeing anything better. Hope they have lands. Okay. We're still alive somehow. That's a nice draw. Of course, we're not gonna attack. I guess if I clear shot this away, gives us a pretty clean path to victory, potentially. So it allows us to just attack freely, have lethal next turn, cut down our opponent's outs, presumably. Okay. Really? Well, I'm going to attack with both. I'm going to play Ghoul Caller's Accomplice and Valdaran Pariah. And then I think we just pass. And we can transform the Pariah in response now to an Alchemist trigger. Okay, so they get to draw off the Mad Prophet. Whew, somehow we won that one. Huh. So, opponent's taking a mulligan. I think on the draw, this is a keep. Could go wrong. But drawing... After drawing one land, I feel pretty good. We also have grapples in our deck. We actually have a decent amount of mana sources. So, yeah, feel good about the keep. Not bad for a mulligan to 5. We do have the Spirit of the Hunt, which we can try to set up. Yeah, the accomplice plus this equipment is scary. Don't think we want to block it. Tricky situation. We do want to hit land, so I guess I'm going to grapple with the past. Okay, no lands. Well, this is frustrating. It's pretty easy to block the skeletons there. Game is interesting though, because also, oh wow, they also have Westvale Abbey, so our opponent's deck is pretty good, and they're doing a lot of annoying stuff, although it does look like they've decided to slow down, which could be good news. But we also just don't have a lot to do. So now we have to start respecting the Westvale Abbey. So I'm going to kill off the token here. And guess play the Spirit of the Hunt. So this Pariah, the transform is not super great here. I guess they can start making 1/1s with Westvale Abbey. Which might be okay for us. We're just gonna double up on these pariahs. I probably shouldn't have played that forest, actually. Because we want to have stuff to discard. But this looks like a good Westville Abbey deck of our opponents. Could transform a pariah here. Don't think it makes that much sense to do so. Probably also doesn't really make sense to cast a rapid bite because there's not good creatures on our opponent's side that we want to kill. Well, that is a development right there. Okay. Their own pariah. I think I just have to let this resolve. I'm really wishing I had cast rapid bite on something, but I don't know how I would have known to do that. Grapple. I honestly don't know what I'm gonna want to grapple into. Right now. But let's see. I mean, I guess I could potentially want the Newscraft Mob. But I don't think I'm gonna need it. Although I could jam it here. Or I can transform one of our pariahs, we'd have to sacrifice the other one. I guess getting the mob out is pretty good. Does seem pretty good. I don't know if it's correct. but starting to get these zombies is pretty beneficial. Because it gives us fodder now to sacrifice. Okay, so now we've kind of set up a pretty good situation, I think. Now we can double rapid bite. So we make them sacrifice their pariah. Close to lethal. I think I'll just put them to one here. Or actually, yeah. Yeah, put them to one and I think we got it. Okay, we have double rapid bite, which isn't great, but we do have. Yeah, I think this is just a clear keep still. We haven't really got a great Pack Guardian moment yet. Maybe this will be the game for that. Don't necessarily hate just grappling right here to try to find a play for next turn. Because otherwise, if we don't, we fall behind. So, yep, here we go. Grapple with the pass. Found a constrictor. Pretty good. Also, now a Byway Courier gives us an option as to what to do. I think I will actually Byway Courier now so that we can potentially constrictor and rapid bite next turn. And let's see, let's see what they do. We are missing the land to be able to discard to the Pack Guardian. Fine with just getting to investigate at this point. I guess I can just Pack Guardian now, or I can. Noose Constrictor is also kind of appealing. I'm gonna Pack Guardian. Don't have the land to discard, but because we've got now a 5 drop and a 6 drop, even if we had a land, we might not discard it. Now, with that being said, they may realize that we have Pack Guardian here. Because otherwise it does our play doesn't make that much sense, right? But if they're not attacking us, then we've got a lot of gas, so that's also fine. And these are the types of things that likely are running through our opponent's head at the moment. So no discard. And now the question is, what do we block? I think I'll just block Elder Cathar. Could have, of course, blocked the inspector, but because we have this rapid bite in hand, I think this makes sense. Although I guess they could have their own fight spell. Ooh. Was not thinking about that card, guys. I will be the first to admit that. I can still kill the inspector, but we'd have to use our second rapid bite. Ugh, that sucks. Did not work. Did not work as I had planned. Think I like our position still, but I do feel a little bit vulnerable. But, like, still so much gas in hand. We can afford to take three. We are incentivized to try to find lands. We have Delirium, so we can activate Kindly Stranger on our next turn. Which our opponent probably realizes at this moment. Question is, if they attack with both, do we want to block? Well, only permeating mass, so it's an easy choice to take that hit. So now I'm just holding up the activation of the kindly stranger. Alright. So we now have a permeating mass. I'm okay with that. Let's see what they got. We still have a lot of good stuff as soon as we find that second black source. Post-combat. I guess they could start moving around that bound. This is kind of a little dicey. Especially not having the second black. I mean, I could have tried to just hold up kindly stranger indefinitely, but I don't think that's realistic. We could be dead here. I mean, if they just move the enchantment and... Alright. Got the pump, too. Wow. I was not expecting that. I guess I could have kept back Noose Constrictor, but GG. We have a tough one here. I guess I'll try it, but I don't love it. We are 3-2. We have two losses, so it's a tough one, but drawing the swamp is really good. I feel much better now about our situation. Courier into Pack Guardian. Fine with making trades. Now that card can be very scary. I guess I could have also Mourn Willowed here. We have to be worried about pump. Well, now with the Pack Guardian, I like a lot just trying to get them with the Pack Guardian. Although it could backfire here. It could backfire. I think based on arena stops, like, I could get the tell there that they didn't have anything, right? Because they didn't have stop set. So that gives us a lot, that gives, can give you a lot of information. Huge, huge amount of information. Because if they have a combat trick there, we get wrecked. We get, you know, all of a sudden we're in a really bad spot. Now we just keep the pressure going. Not too concerned. Our opponent's at 6. And it was really that Pack Guardian turn that won us this game, it looks like. Okay. Seems like we're on the draw a decent amount, but let's try this. Drew a Dragoon. And feel pretty good. Feel pretty good because they didn't play 2. And we may finally have an opportunity to discard a land to the Pack Guardian. Fire Hound. So I could Rapid Bite that. Now. Before it gets, yeah, large. I think getting rid of that against Izzet makes a lot of sense. So I think I could have main phased the Pack Guardian to like play around a counterspell. This is probably better, but not for sure better. Got a sorcery, so we're really looking for like an instant. Okay, that's good. So we can grapple. I think I grapple here, although I could also flip the Howler. Flipping the Howler is kind of good because it creates a 3/5 where they kind of have to block it. Yeah, I'm gonna do that because I think it's gonna benefit us later to have the chorus out, and then getting the Dragoons in the graveyard means that we have a creature in the graveyard, which may be beneficial. And we're trying to set up Kindly Stranger to kill off the Hound. Wow, they've got to take inventory deck here. So So we are getting outcarded. I guess I probably should have just not grappled main phase. I could have ended up turn grappled. So now they know about the pariah. Oh wow. Avacyn's Judgment, that's really strong. That's very strong. I guess the only good thing is that we can kill off the Hound finally, but even still, that's a bit of a blowout. That's definitely a bit of a blowout. I like Izzet. I'm jealous of all of these Izzet synergies. Our opponents had a pretty good draw. I would definitely say that. Besides them not doing anything on turn two, but having the second Hound. After we killed the first Hound. So, do I want to deadweight something here? I can deadweight the cultist. I think I'm just passing. Now that we can pack Guardian. Wow. So much card advantage, so much. That's the third take inventory. Kind of insane. They're actually down to 12 cards left in their deck. We might have found it. Let's see. Let's see if we have lethal. We might have done it. I guess they could have the one blue disruption card. Yes. We did it. We somehow found the win. I wasn't thinking we would. That clear shot off the top. Bang. Let's go. All right. Seems like a relatively easy keep. Couple creatures, couple fight spells. So we can bite that right here. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. I don't want them passing, flipping it, and making life difficult. This is interesting. Noose Constrictor on Noose Constrictor. I'm gonna attack. I could clear shot away theirs. Although in green red, I don't actually know how great Constrictor is. Might have something we need to clear shot instead. Now, though, I will clear shot. Let's see how much they're gonna discard. All right, this may not work out for us. Oopsies, I meant to do this, I meant to also discard that, but I'm gonna cast it. Wow. Okay, well, I didn't know what their hand was, which was part of the gamble of making this play. Keeping the mob though, which was our, I mean, we didn't really lose much at all with that play. Now they didn't lose. They got rid of a bunch of these moonlight hunts, which weren't doing too much, I guess, but now not having the six land does hurt, because I would have loved to just transform there. Or play the new scrap mob, either one. But we never had a sixth, or a second swamp, rather. Let's just attack. I don't want to get blown out by something here. Yikes. I guess I have to do this. Sigh. That was very, very unfortunate and unexpected. Now they can just transform their wolf. Tough game. Hate going out like this. I think, yeah, maybe the Noosecraft mob turn I messed up. Wow. All right, GG. I'm gonna concede this one.